Okay, folks, well, my name's Chuck, Chuck Newt, and I'm with the Winking Pig Barbecue, and I'm getting ready to get started on a new project here, a new welding project to start with. It is the 22nd day of March in 2018, and so this is like the second day of spring, and believe it or not, yesterday we had about 3 inches of snow covering this ground. So it has warmed up a little bit. It's up in the 40s right now. And so I'm getting ready to get started on this spring project here. And so let me get turned around and show you what we got going on. I got a little bit of a safety note for you to start with. Okay? All right, so what I got here is a 55-gallon drum. Actually, I've got two of them. I got another one sitting back over there. But this is going to be one project at a time. And so it's a 55-gallon drum. And here's my word of warning. You see this drum has what's known as petroleum or POE if you're in the military. And which means that in this case it had looks like motor oil in here. And so that's a concern, especially if you are operating any kind of torches around this, trying to cut into this barrel. So you definitely do not want to be using oxyacetylene torches on this barrel to try to cut it open with. The reason being is because oxygen is an accelerator and it can cause this barrel, even with the bungs out of it, it could still conceivably explode. And for that reason, anything that has ever had any kind of petroleum or gasoline or benzene or any of that kind of stuff in it, you definitely do not want to be using oxyacetylene torches or any kind of torch with a flame, especially if it's got some of that more flammable stuff like trying to get my focus. My camera is not focusing very well here. I don't know what the heck's going on with it. So at any rate, you definitely do not want to be using torches around this kind of material to construct your, in this case, it's going to be a barbecue grill. Now then, you're going to have to bear with me as we move along with this, because I have never built a grill out of a 55-gallon drum. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of, having to sit back and figure things out as I go along here. Oh, by the way, I'm going to put down a link down below to a video from one of the other people on YouTube here that builds grills and smokers and stuff out of 55-gallon drums. And in that video, you will see it's Alan's welding and woodworking channel, and in that video you will see the aftermath of somebody who has used torches on a 55-gallon drum that had flammable material on the inside inside the drum and what it can do to you. Thankfully Alan survived, but you're gonna see him looking pretty rough after the explosion. And it's not a joking matter or anything like that. I am certainly not laughing at the man. And thank the Lord he is alive and well and talking about it today. And so I want to definitely give you folks the word of warning. And so I also today, to go along with the barrel, I went, it's here in the back of the truck, I've got some steel that I went to pick up today from the steel yard. Some 1-inch tubing and a piece of flat steel here that I'm going to be using to make the carriage underneath the smoker with. So there we go, folks. So I want you to stay tuned with me. I got to do some ciphering figure out how this carriage is going to fit up underneath this barrel. That's going to be my first project, I think, even before I cut the barrel open. So here we go. Do me a favor, folks. If you like what you're seeing, hit like and subscribe. And stay tuned. There's always more to come.